Hey everybody, Rusty reporting in from the 1st St. Mark's BPSA Otter Scout Troop here in Sussex Corner, New Brunswick, and today we're going to be talking about one of my all-time favorite moths, the Rosy-maple moth. And fun fact, I actually have a really cool cross stitch on my desk from one of my good pals, Martha Wallace. Thanks, Martha. The Rosy-maple moth is one of the most recognizable moths on the planet. That is because of the moth's beautiful coloration. This little guy can come with many different wing designs, but they always sport a beautiful bright yellow body, a little pink face, and pink legs, and gorgeous pink and yellow wings. Now, it's a little bit trickier to tell the gender of a moth than, say, like a bird. But the first clue to look for is their antenna. If the moth has antenna that look like feathers, then it's a boy. If they have antenna that look like twigs, then it's a girl. The second clue is just their size. The male Rosy-maple moth is generally larger than the female. A male's wingspan can get up to 55 millimeters wide. That's roughly the size of two loonies side by side. It's easy to tell where these beautiful critters get their name. The rosy, which is another word for pink, maple moth, which means they live on maple trees. So, with a moth that is this beautiful, the caterpillar must be beautiful too. Nice pink, yellow, right? The Rosy-maple moth caterpillar actually changes colors as it continues to grow. When it starts off, it has a black head and a yellow body. But as it continues to eat, its body will turn green and their head will turn red. After they eat enough, they will pupate and emerge as that beautiful pink moth. Like most moths, the Rosy-maple is most active at night. They actually live most of their lives by themselves until they're ready to lay eggs. The Rosy-maple lays its eggs under a leaf, and when those Rosy-maple moths grow up, they actually return to the same plant. So, if you ever find some Rosy-maple moths in your backyard, there's a very good chance that you'll see them every year. Needless to say, the Rosy-maple is one of the most beautiful moths that North America has to offer. They live up to their name and stun audiences when they're found. That's all for this episode on a moth that people like to call the cotton candy moth. I hope you get to see one of these guys around your home. Until next time, Rusty out.